lot of people from Durban, like Mr. Bokelin, George, we got a little call from Turia. Yeah, press up. Looks like a good turnout. We'll see what happens. Yeah.
Party, about party, yeah. And the guys, some guys from them, but yeah, I know.
Nothing, Alan. I haven't seen him skate for practice, kicking ass out there. She bleeds to die alone.
And swallow, to my soul I fall. Don't know where we're going. Shit's falling apart, son. We had to stop by the Armchair Theatre to speak to Carl, to calm Carl's nerves, because Carl's worried because it's going to rain tomorrow. 100% forecast of rain.
We have the Roswell Kings in here. We have Andy from the Roswell Kings.
Today's been a bit stressful. We've got our album launch tomorrow evening, and so we've been running around like headless chickens. The idea behind the evening is this carnival theatre performance art, just weird ass evening that's just going to be amazing. The Roswell King started with myself and two other chaps in early 2000. And eventually, about 2 years ago, we arrived at the lineup that we have now, which is myself on vocals and guitar, Dylan Dalton on guitar, Jason Ling on bass, and Matthew Waits on drums.
Yeah.
We took 2 months. We went up to Pretoria, a really nice studio up there called Rooftop Studios, owned by the chaps from the band The Narrow, and we spent 2 months recording. It's a really full album that if anybody likes any kind of alternative music, and even if you don't, if you like Justin Timberlake, there's none of that on there, but I mean, hey, buy it anyway. If it's like this, if it's light rain, I think we'll be okay, but Cape Town's so fickle when it rains, dude. But you never know, people are going to be coming out to the launch for the launch, so.
Launch, dude, our launch, finally. Just waiting for beer, we're gonna get some court to take the edge off. Hoping it doesn't rain, as you can see, it's not the greatest of weather.
It's gotta go down either which way, so.
This is our banner, which
Dylan did a very rushed job, but it came out alright, so we're quite stoked. Hopefully, we figure out a way how to hang it up, it should be quite effective.
Finished sound check. We finalizing the last pieces of what we need to do. It's all aesthetics for now. You gotta sort out downstairs, outside the area, what it looks like.
We're a bit nervous because, as you know, Thursday was the day where the CDs were dropped, and we hadn't had to listen to the final master, so. Kind of stoked that it turned out the way it did. It sounded good.
Yeah, Boot Camp Records couldn't have, you know, can't thank you guys enough, especially Garth, you rock, bro. Way she moves, make up and
tears, run down her clothes. Ready, the most house here, 5 minutes on stage. Feeling good, good makeup, good outfits.
This is where it ends. But when she sings,
we'll be right back.
Thank you. the curve ball will rise and never fall. Yes, I'm on the mic, but that's not such a big hole. I got my brothers, together we stand tall. I hear people call, but we'll never stop. Keeping it real, yes, we rise to the top. Like the cream of the crop, the key to your lock. And like body callous, yeah, we love to rock. Rhythmic rhyme rapping is my natural high. Without daily doses, yo, I get uptight. Hot and cold sweats all through the night. I'm a rapaholic, yo, so give me that mic.
How low can you go when you're so close? How low?
One of the coolest bands in the country at the moment. Put your hands together for Valve!
I'm Ben's Valve. We've been together for about 2 years and we're from Durban.
We used to be Valve Mary, and then 2 years later, we changed the name to Valve. While when you're on stage, you feel the moment, and you feel the song, and you feel the crowd, and you feel everything, so you just express yourself.
It's everything to do with like bringing over across this emotion and this mood. It's all about that.
Other people have got skateboarding, some people have got bodyboarding. We've got the band, same thing. It's a way of expressing yourself.
The way I put the fear in you.
Okay, basically when we rehearse, we just go, take a guitar, pop it in the boot, drive outside, smoke a cigarette, wait for everybody to get there.
We've got our own jam room, like, outside of Durbanville, so everything's already there. In this airplane hangar.
Like, we jam some old songs and then we'll start working on some new stuff.
I will. So glad to see you. Ball of Brady's shadow.
Like, you'd write a couple of riffs, maybe it like comes up with some ideas and we take it and then we work on it. Then we like, you get this picture in your mind of, okay, this is going to be this first section, this is going to be the second section, the third section. The whole band gives the input, everybody, and then he writes his vocals, or goes home and writes his vocals.
Everybody has to be happy with their part in the song and has to feel their part. And after that, only I'll go and sit by myself and then do my part.
Chris, like, jumped on the team, and he's like
a good friend of ours.
Yeah, he's a good friend of ours, and he's putting us across visually. It was the first song we ever recorded with one of our previous drummers in his like garage, and we gave it to some people, and people got hold of it, and then Chris got hold of it before we even knew him, and he just loves that song, and like it's basically his interpretation of what the song is
about.
Take
what you need just to breathe as I give it all to you.
I think the people that listen to Valve's people that doesn't feel anything for the norm, the standard kind of music that you get it, like every day. They're looking for something new.
And we don't do the band for like pleasing anybody else. We just do the band because we do what we like, the way we like it, and that's it.
Sometimes you feel like, okay, if we actually want to get on radio, we have to compromise a little bit, and like not compromise but go in a direction that we never thought about before. And then we write songs like Fallen and stuff that's a bit more commercial but still us.
Since we evolved the same, a ball of dust. And though these dreams kind of lift me up, it's not enough.
The Cape Town music scene has building at the moment. It's like, it's huge, actually. It's starting to pick up quite rapidly. And so if you want like a book a real cool show, you have to book months in advance. They see a flyer somewhere, they come to the show, they think, yo, cool show. We're lucky to be in a band, and it's like living the life, whatever. But it's a lot of work that's you have to do behind them. I mean, the flyer they picked up somewhere in Pickwick's or wherever, we had to go out like 5 days, whatever.
Design it, print it, take it there, put it there. For the show itself, you just do as much as possible, like from the sound and lighting and like effects and inside decor, and you must be very well like rehearsed. Save me. Are you falling with broken wings? I need to feel the way that you rise above anything. Did you come down to save me? For I'm bleeding to believe. I fear to be.
Cameraman.
Woo!
Hold me.
Woo!
You make me chill me,
yeah.
You give me home me,
oh.
I wanna be dead, me. You make me chill me,
oh.
You make me chill to me, you make fun me, home me, yeah.
Woo!
Thank you. with you. I've been meaning to play with you. I've been meaning to play with you.
Their house. Me and Johnny stay on the other side of the hill.
In front of went to Babel High School with the three of them were in Dave Miller.
Cool. And they were in a band, and we were in a band, and we were in a band long ago. So we know each other.
There's the office.
This is where we run the operation from. All our merchandise, our t-shirts.
This is Pukkelpop. That's where we played in Belgium. Kitchen! We're gonna bribe these babies tonight.
How's the Kennedy's room?
Toilet number one.
This is our Uncle's conscious room.
He's got his little talk sucky there from when he was, I don't know what that is, and that's it. Yeah, Uncle is the poorest man in the band.
And then it's me and my girlfriend's room.
This place is also old, actually.
That is my band. Our road manager. The three of us decided, yeah, we want to do this thing. We've been talking about it for 3 years, you know. We want to start this band or whatever. And when you move inside, like, what's not happening anymore, we got together and we decided we wanted Snake for drums.
And their band also was at the same time, 20%.
And we wanted Snakes. And then one day we went to practice at Johnny's place. And we were like, Johnny's quite good. Do you want to join the band? Yeah, why not? You know?
I think the first day we jammed, I was still supposed to play guitar and sing. And I don't know why I was supposed to sing. I think Valen came up with that idea. Oh, Francis would sing. Okay! It was like that.
No, because there was a thing that he could do best. Yeah. And they'll be like, yo, we've got that idea for chorus, go like it's four chorus. And then he'll be like, then no, he'll be like,
we don't know if we should do it.
Why did you get it? Like, why did you hate the school? And then he'll be like, yo, you know, like, they always will tune us when we smoke cigarettes. And they're like, yo, what the fuck, they're going to do it. Then everyone just make up a line, you know, and that's how the first few songs got written.
Yeah.
We all came together, all five of us, and the basic thing was, like, we all know that we want to make music, you know. Like, I know giants want to make music, you know, if you can just play drums, it'd be cool, you know. But obviously it's not that easy in this country just to make music and make a living, you know. But we're still young, so it's fine. So we decided that if we do this thing, we're going to do it well, you know. Like, from all aspects, yeah, proper. And I've just got the best ability to write lyrics. So most of the lyrics from the album he's written, and Johnny's very good with like production, you know, and like song structure and chords and stuff like that. So he puts a lot of the songs together, but then Yaku will give input, you know, and Francho will write lyrics and write his own stuff, or melodies or even riffs or whatever, and I'll like put in two or three words or maybe a sentence or a chorus or whatever, and that's it, you know.
Yeah, and if a person has an idea, we always try it, you know, and we first try it before we sort of shoot it down.
The average fan would probably be someone from Belleville in his early 20s.
But then, you know, like when we get mails of school, like kids at school, you know.
Like even primary fans, school kids.
We get from Tunnies that are on the potluck.
Yeah. All the people, you know, we get old buddies that I show.
I think the most common denominator would be like an Afrikaans person who's sort of tired of the stigma attached to Afrikaans people, you know. And they really appreciate the fact that we're trying to break away from it, because they obviously want to break away from it themselves.
Fuck off! Fuck off, police guard! Fuck you! Fuck you, police man! Fuck off! Fuck off, police guard! Fuck you! Fuck you, police man!
Solid drummer, good lead guitarist,
good
crazy vocalist,
good lyrics.
Yeah. There you go.
And the song, basically.
although it's a bit off key and maybe a bit weird sometimes or whatever, I think it carries like heavy pop sensibility to it. I think we're still like sort of like finding ourselves, only been existing for a year and a half, you know. But I think there's a lot of melody and a lot of like, you know, just cool stuff happening, you know. I think like we've obviously like, I think we've got a brilliant songwriters in this band, you know, and a lot of ability as musicians or whatever. And I think people just catch on to that. And then obviously fucking hard work and all that.
I decided to start a skateboard company. The idea was there about halfway through last year. Mischief is basically just my own lifestyle type of thing. You're always getting into trouble about doing something that's not really that bad. Like skateboarding, your skateboarding is mischief. Eventually I decided not to do the company with anyone that's already got a big company going or anything like that, so I hooked up with Bob's, who's just a good friend of mine. So I went through a stage where nothing was really happening and it almost sort of didn't happen, and now everything's coming together. You try to understand the reason why I stand here. It's quite good at the moment, but it could only get better, and that all depends on the skateboarders if they're going to support the local companies. Skateboarders don't really have money, and they're always looking for the cheapest deal, because that's what I used to do. Like, all my friends and people say that they're going to support the company, but we're going to have to see what happens when it's actually for sale in the shops, and hopefully they will.
Ek sal julle nooit tevrede. tevreden stel nu. Hou jou kop vast, die probleem is net dat ek nie weet wie ek is nie. En hierdie kan nog lang vat, hierdie kan nog seer maak. Kan ons maak of ons verewig kan leef? Sal ons ons geheime boodskappen vergeet? Fluister klip en speel so sag as wat jy kan. Soek soveel as wat jy wou. Soek soveel as wat jy wou. En hierdie gaan nog lang wat, hierdie gaan nog.